Hi. Australia keeps opening doors for international people to come and fill up the gaps in the labor market. A number of sectors are giving international people an opportunity to come over and fill up these job shortages. Police officers are also included in this. Yes, Australian government is recruiting police officers from all over the world. Yes, international police officers from all over the world, not any from any specific area. So if you think this is for you, stay tuned and hear how Australia is recruiting the police officers. Guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Keke Letso, aka Keke. This is Bopilo with Keke. Yes, the channel's name is Bopilo with Keke. Bopilo meaning life. So this is life with Keke. Okay, if you are new here, welcome to the channel and please remember to subscribe. And my regular viewers, thank you so much. It is because of you that this channel is still up and running. I appreciate that. Thank you. Okay, without wasting any time, Australia is also looking for police officers. To be specific, in Queensland state, yes, Queensland Police Service is looking for police officers to come and join their police force. Australia keeps coming up with new labor agreements to make it easy for international people to come over and work in Australia. What really happens with labor agreements is that restrictions are eased. Requirements are easy and the process is made simple to follow. Okay, just to give you a brief history about recruitment of police officers from overseas, Australia, to be specific, Queensland has been doing this for about 5 years now, but the requirements were so restrictive, so they couldn't get enough people that they want. One of the requirements was that one needs to be having a permanent residency in Australia, which means they needed people that probably are already in Australia, maybe came through their spouse or other means. But now they want to recruit straight from overseas. You don't need to be having permanent residence. That's why they came up with this new labor agreement. It means they are going to sponsor you from wherever you are, from the country that you are in, and you come straight here already coming to join the service. Being a police officer in Queensland means you're going to make good money. Yes, you're going to be paid very well. So let's look at the benefits that you get when you are a police officer in Queensland. All right, this is interesting. So they say under the contract of employment, police recruits receive an allowance of 1,811.53 cross per fortnight. So remember, in Australia, they pay every 2 weeks. So every 2 weeks, you are going to get an allowance of 1,811 when you are a recruit. This is when you are still doing the training before you can be fully employed, unless you are coming straight as through the employment route. It said the starting salary on a first-year constable is 84,999 per annum. There are two bands, this one for a constable and a senior constable, so you can see how much you are really going to earn. And the benefits, they say 6 weeks recreation leave per year, 13 weeks long service leave after 10 years of service, and a 38 hour working week. You're only going to do 38 hours. That's 9 days off in every 28 days roster. Overtime paid for work beyond roster hours, 114 hour sick leave per year, access to paid parental and maternity leave, access to leave for carers, bereavement or emergency reasons, Australian Defence Force, reserves, study and sporting commitments, free supply of uniform, access to a wide variety of training opportunities, additional travel allowances and financial incentives for officers working in remote areas, the security of being a member of the Q superannuation scheme. This those retirement packages. That's just a bit of what they offer. You won't have to worry about the cost of living, because if the pay is good, why do you have to worry about the cost of living? Because you can afford that.
Without wasting any time,
let's dig in and see the requirements and how you can apply to join this Queensland Police Services. Like I always do, we are going to go through the website together so that you can see that this information is real, it's legit, it's genuine.
The information is extracted from www.police.queenslandgovernment.au. So now we see on this website, it will say International Police Recruitment. Okay, let's hear what they are saying. It says foreign nationals with policing experience can apply to the Queensland Police Service without the requirement to be Australian citizen or permanent residence. Okay, that's nice. The information is extracted from the website www.police.queensland.government.au. So if we see, this is Queensland Police Service Recruitment and we are on International Police Recruitment. It says foreign nationals with policing experience can apply to Queensland Police Services, which is QPS. Okay, now let's see the eligibility. Officers with international police experience can apply to join the QPS. Your previous experience may be recognized through the QPS Police Abridged Competency Education, which is PACE. This PACE is a program that evaluates whether your experience qualifies to meet their criteria. Yes. So it says if your experience isn't applicable or recent, you may need to undertake the mainstream recruit training to ensure you meet the standard of the QPS. So if at the moment you don't meet the PACE or the program experience, like your experience doesn't meet this PACE, then you have to go through the training that they will allocate you to do the training that they are talking about. Yes, they say applicants must also meet Department of Migration visa eligibility requirements. So these are the requirements that are going to be needed when you are now applying for what? For the visa. But they are saying they want you already to what? To meet this criteria, so that if they decide that we are taking this person, it's not that you're still going to start to look for, to gather things that they need. The visa eligibility requirements are be working under a current labor agreement, which is this one for the police. It means you would have been recruited, and you have the English language skills, which is equivalent or higher than skills 6, meaning if you are going to write IELTS, you need to score 6 or above, and you need to be nominated by the QPS and as an Australian employer who is a party to labor agreement. So obviously you need to be recruited by the QPS, and you need to be under the age of 55 when you apply. Unfortunately, here there is age limit, which is 55. Meet the health requirements. They are going to do, they'll let you know if they decide they are taking you, which health requirements or health tests that are going to be done. Meet the character requirements. This one are the police checks. Sign the Australian value statement, which they are going to give you. Ensure any debts owed to the Australian governments are finished. If you owe any, if maybe let's say you were at school here or whatever, but this is for international, so I assume you don't owe Australian government, and you do not have a visa cancelled or previous application refused, meaning you have never applied to come to Australia and no visa was cancelled or no visa was refused. So how to apply? Okay, international officers must meet all pre-application requirements and assessments, including, so before you apply, you hear, these are pre-application requirements. Before you apply, those ones that we talked about are for the visa, but they also want to see that you have those. So this one's before you apply, they say you need to have what? QPS entrance assessment. So that's what you are going to do, this assessment. If you click on it, it will lead you on that assessment, what you need to do. And applicants who hold a tertiary degree, if when you are practicing as a police officer, maybe you specialize, you did degree in whatever profession you are doing, you are going to be exempted from doing the QPS, meaning this assessment is not going to be done if you hold a degree, like degree, maybe whatever thing that you studied. Yeah. From the 9th May, that was in May, QPS recruiting will be covering the cost of the following. So that's nice. QPS entrance assessment. So this assessment that they want you to do, they are going to cover it. And medical assessments, those ones up there, excluding general practitioner, specialists, non-standard medical assessments, they are not going to cover those ones. All other costs must be met by the applicant. Okay, other costs are going to be met by you, like writing the English test. But this specific ones, they are going to cover. Okay. The other thing is psychological assessment. Those are the things that will be done. Panel interview, a medical assessment with QPS approved medical provider. They are going to do those ones. QPS recruit entry fitness assessment, comprehensive integrity vetting, community background inquiries. They are going to also find out from the community if you are a good person or not. I don't know how they are going to do it if you are from international, but they have ways of doing such things. And the referee checks, meaning your references, they really are going to look at them. So be sure that the references that you are going to write there are people that you know are going to represent you well when they are contacted, because these people really contact the referees. Okay. They say we may take into consideration your length of policing service. So if you have more experience, then you are, yeah, they are going to consider that. Reason for your separation from your previous policing employer, they may look at that. Meaning they might not even look at that, but they might also look at that. Okay. Conduct while a police officer, including disciplinary history, the rank you had attained, the nature, variety, and experience of your previous police duties, time elapsed since your separation, if maybe you have left the police job. Okay. So they are saying for more information, if you want to know about the recruitment process, you go on this website. That's where you'll find all the information. Recruiting International Police, queensland.gov.au. Okay, I can probably just go into this quickly. So this is just the process. So they are saying steps in the recruitment process. The first one, successful completion of Queensland Police Service entrance assessments, meaning the first thing that you do is to do the assessment. Then you'll be invited to submit online application. If on the assessment you pass the assessment, you'll be invited to submit online application. Then after that, there'll be physical assessment. This is QPS recruit entry fitness assessment, the psychological assessment, panel interview. They're going to do the interview, then they do the medical testing, then integrity, background, and referee checks. Then if all passes, you are ready to go. You can come here and work and join the Queensland Police Services.
Those are the requirements and the process for you to join the Queensland Police Service. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you find this video helpful. If you did, remember to like. And if you have not subscribed, remember to subscribe, because there are a lot of opportunities that this girl is going to share with you. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you all the best. Bye.